Which ones did you think, David?
So the first sentence, colorless green ideas sleep furiously, I recognize pretty quickly as a pretty famous example proposed by Noam Chomsky of how sentences can be semantically nonsensical but still grammatically correct. The sentence makes sense. There's still a subject, a verb, an adverb describing the verb, but the idea of a colorless green idea makes no sense. The idea of ideas sleeping makes maybe a little bit of sense. The idea of sleeping furiously is kind of nonsense, so the sentence really doesn't have much meaning, even though it's grammatically correct. The second sentence, soft drinks due from Thank Bill's insurance, really doesn't make any grammatical sense. It does have a seeming subject and a seeming verb, but the verb comes right after a preposition, suggesting that the verb fills in the slot proposed by the preposition, which doesn't make any sense. So this one doesn't make any grammatical sense to me. The same can be said for the other two negative examples. They don't really have the normal subject-predicate sentence structure, or they have other rules or constraints that are being violated. For the other two positive examples, they still maintain this subject-verb sentence structure. So here we have Waldcorn notifies, which doesn't make sense, but it matches our structure. And here we have Tuesday brought something, which also makes no semantic sense, but can still be thought of as grammatically correct. Similarly, Tuesday bringing something does make some sense, but a sharp-edged sweet of pumpernickel makes no sense whatsoever.
Note the vocabulary that David used in trying to find out which of these sentences were grammatically correct. It seemed to me that he was examining if the structure of these sentences was fulfilling certain conditions or fulfilling certain constraints that he expects from his knowledge of English language grammar. One could even say that he was doing constraint processing.